English is not correct. If you have any questions, if you have any unclear points, let me know in any time, anywhere, anyhow you want. Right? Thank you very much. Thank you. So I'm not good at speaking English language, but I love programming languages very much. So the title of my talk is Structured Data Representation for Ruby, Groovy, and Scala. Here is an agenda of today's talk. One, I'm going to talk about myself. Secondary, I'm talking about Starbucks as an example of structured data. Thirdly, this is main topic, I'm going to talk about six serialization techniques. Those are object serialization in Java, IDL, Xtreme, protocol buffers, Apache Avro, and the Swift. Last one is new structured data representation I designed called RugsOn. So this work is supported by JSD, which stands for Japan Science and Technology Agency, and it's one of the department to manage government funds. This trip is supported by the government. It's a problem to me. First of all, I have to say sorry. I have not released my product yet based on the project. At the status, the government staff said that I should not talk everything because of patent-related things. I'm very sorry, but I'm trying to talk as much as possible right now. If you feel boring during my talk, or if you are interested in my talk, please look at my web pages, www.rugsOn.org. I wrote some web pages about structured data representation since last week. You can download samples for serialization techniques and one of my papers. Moreover, I will upload my presentation slides here soon. I will start to open some programs in December, I hope. Here's my background. I work at the university to give lectures about Java programming and software development. I do some research projects about web applications, XML, and compiler construction. Moreover, I have some joint projects with software companies to develop compiler frontends. The compiler, the programming languages of the compiler frontends I have ever developed for commercial products were VHDL, hardware discrete language, Java, SQL, C#, Visual Basic, and so on. But I don't have any graduate students. I'm a solo player. It means that I develop a software by myself. Probably I write 20K to 50K lines of source code per 1 year. For the past few years, I developed reverse engineering tools to get design information from source code and Java compiler frontend for Java 5 syntax and a library for diagram editor, which was built by a company like this. This work is based on the experiences in developing commercial products. So why I'm here? When I was a university student, I learned a lot from BSD Unix 4.1 and 4.2 and GNU GCC compiler. Sometimes I have read source code of Unix to look inside the system. But when I develop programs, all of the programs I have developed were commercial and closed source code. I have never contributed to open source software. In this year, there were disasters in many places over the world. For example, you know, earthquake in New Zealand in February, and in Japan in March. And this is not computer-related things, but I show you this slide. I can believe that mega earthquake with magnitude 9.0 occurred in Japan on March. Total image reference length reached 400 kilometers, with a fault wave with 8 or 90 kilometers. GPS shows that in the worst case, a point moves horizontal about 5.3 meters, but and to southeast, but vertically about 1.2 meters going down in the very short time. I can believe that. So, and the disaster changed my mind. I want to contribute something to someone somewhere. This is why I'm here. Right? Thank you very much. So let's turn to Starbucks as an example of structured data. I love Starbucks very much, but I'm surprised that there are no Starbucks in Canberra, right? Is it true? Why? I don't know. So anyway, this is the picture I bought at Starbucks near to my home. Here's a receipt written in Japanese. So I to translate, grande coffee frappuccino with short extra white with hazelnut, caramel sauce, and chocolate chip is wonderful. I like it very much. I had the same order in Thailand in October last month. I was surprised at this large whipped mountain around there. I enjoyed this drink. So I can write in the XML. Yeah, okay. So order element has 5 elements, product, size, date, price, and the 6 options there. The size of this hand-coded data is 418 bytes. So you know, XML is everywhere. XML is widely used in many applications. In the compiler, it's the same thing. A compiler is source code and builds a tree to represent the structure of source code. It's called abstract syntax tree, which is called short tree SD. Usually the compiler does not export the SD out of the compiler. But if the compiler exports SD, it becomes easy to develop some software tools, for example, reverse engineering tool or a source code search engine, and so on. So researchers developed JavaML in XML. Here's an example from World Wide Web Conference 2000. Right hand side is Java source code, and the left hand side is an SD in XML. JavaML compiler with the source code creates SD and write XML documents. This is one of the examples for the structured data representation in XML. So again, you know, XML is widely used in many applications, but I think XML has positive side and negative side. On the positive side, XML supports platform independence of programming languages, operating systems, and computers. There are many libraries, DOM, SACS, XPath, XSys, SOAP, and so on. This is great. But on the negative side, I usually say that there are 7 problems of highly ineffective XML, like this famous book by Stephen Covey. There are many ugly tags. It's human readable, but it's difficult to read. Sometimes I think which is better at attribute-based or element-based, and it's hard to run many applications, XML schema, XLT, XML query, WS star. It's hard to implement a bunch of XML specifications. Namespace is great, but it makes complicated XML applications. There are mismatch between DOM APIs and application APIs. So I designed my data representation. It's RugsOn. Before talking about RugsOn, I will talk about 6 serialization techniques. Those are object serialization in Java, IDL, Xstream, protocol buffers, Apache Avro, and Thrift. This XML data shows the structure and the contents of data like this diagram. If you program, write it down to a file, you need a program to write here. Come. This is serialization. First thing is serialization in Java. Java standard library supports serialization, of course. We don't need schema definition. All we have to do is to write implements serializable. When your program writes it down to a file, you can use object output stream. It looks up class definitions using reflection and write data stream. Here is a hex dump result of serialized binary data. This binary file includes data with type information, for example, here, Jabrang string or something, includes data with type information. So the size of the file is a larger bit, 516 bytes. In the case of serialization in Java, schema is not required, schema compiler is not provided, binary file is supported, only Java is supported. Second one is ideal to serialize in C. Diana is old technology, which is an intermediate language used to represent the semantics of an Ada program, which was designed in 1980s. It was defined in IDL. And using IDL, I can write this schema here, and schema definition here for the Starbucks data. Order has a product size, date, price options. Option has name and price. It's very simple. IDL compiler reads the schema definition and generates a reader, writer, and some macros for C languages. C language. In the macros, we can use new order MROC in the blue car one. Type conversion of grounded to cup size, green car one. And writers here, and the readers here. It's very simple. This is an output from the writer in ASCII representation. Very simple. Here's a order, and order has options, date, price, products. The size of the file is 339 bytes. The IDL is supposed to write in binary representation. Here is a hex dump result. The size of the file is 135 bytes. Okay. And in the case of IDL, schema is required. Schema compiler is provided, and ASCII and binary are supported, and C and Pascal are supported at that time. Third one is Xtreme. It's library to serialize object to XML, and there are many features. It's ease of use, no mapping is required, and it provides good performance and clean XML, blah, blah, blah. Left-hand side is writer here, and the right-hand side, and readers. Very simple. Here is a serialized XML data. The size is 756 bytes. In the case of Xtreme, and schema definition is not required, schema compiler is not provided, asking XML is provided, only Java is supported. Fourth one, the protocol buffers. I heard that Google uses these protocol buffers for internal remote procedure call protocols, and currently, there are three programming languages that supported Java, C++, and Python. Here is a schema, the definitions. Order has five fields. The unique field numbers are required here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Schema compiler reads the definition and generate a serializer at the C serializer and accessors. In the program, we need an object builder. It's to encapsulate the internal structure. Left hand side here is a writer, and the reader is very simple. And here is a hex dump of serialized binary data. First byte here, has a field number one and string type information. Second type is the length of next value. It's 18 bytes for coffee frappuccino. So the size of protocol buffer is 143 bytes. In the case of protocol buffer, schema definition is required, schema compiler is provided, and binary is supported, that's only binary is supported, and three programming languages, Java, C++, Python are supported. Five is about Avro. The important point is that code generation is not required, but schema definition is required. Here is a schema definition for Avro, written in JSON, and very simple. And here is the order, have five fields, product, size, date, price, options. This is simple descriptions in JSON. In the program, first part is to read the schema definition at runtime. Second part is set values to fields. Third part is write object using binary encoder. And here is a example of a serialized binary file. The size of the serialized data is 123 bytes. If we want to serialize in JSON, all we have to do is to change encoder to JSON encoder here. Here is a real serialized data in JSON, and I formatted cleanly here. It's very clear. So in the Avro, the binary data, the size of the binary data 123 bytes, and the JSON data, the size of JSON data file 298 bytes. In the case of Avro, and schema definition is required, and the schema compiler is not provided, and both binary file and JSON file are supported, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six languages are supported, C, C++, C Sharp, Java, PHP, and Python. Last one is the Thrift. I heard Thrift was developed and used by Facebook, and then was denoted to the Apache. The key point is that Thrift support 14 programming languages, a bunch of programming languages right there. And here's the schema definition for Thrift, and very simple description. And here's the option, order, have a five fields, but we need the unique field numbers. And Thrift support four types of format, binary, compact binary, and JSON, and simple JSON format. So at last, and here is the size of comparison of serialized data. The smallest one is in the case of Avro binary, and the largest one is extreme. And in the Thrift, schema is required, and the schema compiler is provided, and ASCII and binary are supported, and 14 languages are supported. Okay, let's turn to my own data representation RugsOn. Here's a DSL talk. I have a bunch of slides, 100 slides, so I'm going to skip this slide. I like this language dot is a kind of DSL for draw diagram. So if you have a graph bits, you can draw the diagram from the dot program. Here's an external DSL, and it's a language separate from the main language of the application it works with. For example, and SQL, org, and XML configuration, or dot. And here is a DSL in Ruby and Java. And this is a Starbucks example. Frappuccino, grande, short, and cheap, and method call in Ruby. And here is my computer's configuration. This is Mac. Method chaining core in Java, computer have a processor, Core 7, Core 4, speed 2 gigahertz, and so on. So this is internal DSL. And the important point is that it only uses subset of the language features, in particular style, to handle one small aspect of something. RugsOn is an internal DSL. It's sort of I talk about the previous version, a readable. It's an internal DSL to represent structured data in Ruby. It was released about 3 years ago for commercial products. It's not open source software. Readable is an object notation like YAML or JSON. The design principle is to be simple for high readability using Ruby syntax. This one here is called an element readable. An element has a name and value. In this example, the name is config, the value is a string, my behavior. The element is not only data representation, but also a method call. In the Ruby's method call, parentheses is optional. Readable supports four features, child elements, configured before by add, and when each line in readable rolls into the Ruby interpreter on Java VM, the method is called each by each so that Java object can be created like this. Just skip the slide. Second is primitive data types, integer, real, boolean, and string, very simple primitive data types. And these are represented by elements with the same name. In this example, there are three order elements. The values are grande, hot, double short. Last one is links across the structure. Links are represented using symbols in Ruby. The symbol in Ruby is defined by prefixing colon with identifier like this. In this example, UUID element is given to the element. It means that the UID of the at element is DB0C, blah, blah, blah. Another element refers to the element using a symbol in Ruby. So these elements show only one shared object. The symbol for UID is generated in Ribbons classes, but we can change the value manually. So before using a ribbon, we have to define the structure of data schema definition. The definition is also in Ruby syntax. Here is a simple definition here. Config has a payout, and the pay has a price tag to go, or something. I developed a generation tool called RevGen. RevGen reads the schema definition and the language-specific definition and generates Java files. In this example, basically six Java files are generated corresponding to the six elements. So here is an example to read, write very simple Java object using generated classes by RevGen. And okay, I did the performance evaluation to examine the performance of Ribbon. Two experiments were designed using this hardware software. It was 3 years ago, very old laptop PC and Windows XP. I have used, and I use JRuby with 8 versions. I use 159 Ribbon data files made by diagram. So total files, total of all files, 94 kilo lines. And the program was executed and 159 dots are plotted in this graph. The problem is that it takes about 4 seconds to read one smallest file. I think JRuby carried the performance penalty. It consumed too much time to initialize the interpreter and to execute ribbon-related Ruby code. So I modified RevGen to eliminate the JRuby interpreter called RevGen 2. It generates faster Java programs containing a definition for JFlex scanner generator, a definition for BACJF and parser generator, and ASC builder. So here is a comparison between two types. The average time of program one is about 5 seconds. The average time of programs is about 300 milliseconds. Of course, this result shows the Java programs of RevGen 2 is extremely faster than by RevGen. So, okay. I talked about previous version readable. It was released about 3 years ago for commercial products. I redesigned it to support Ruby, Groovy, and Scala. This is current version called RugsOn. RugsOn is an object notation like JSON, and here is a very simple example. The value string November 70s, and the name is date. So what should I do? So primitive data, 9 data types are supported, and collections are represented by elements with the same name. And links are represented using strings. In this example, a UID element is here given to the place element. It means that the UID of the place element, column, blah, blah, blah. Another place element here refers to the element using the string. So this element is shared with our readable object. And before using RugsOn, we have to define a schema definition. The definition is also in Ruby syntax. Here is an example of the definitions. So, okay, I sum up. I talked about six relative techniques. There are serialization, IDLs, extreme, protocol buffers, Avro, Swift, and I talked about comparative surveys. I talked about Ribbon, it is the previous version for only Ruby. I'm now developing software tools for RugsOn. I will read them in the near future, December, I hope. That's all. Thank you very much.